Hello everyone, welcome to part 12, module 6, data communication. So we already discussed the frequency hopping spread spectrum concept in our previous discussion, and now we move on to the different category of spread spectrum technique called the direct sequence spread spectrum. We will see how it is working. So with direct sequence spread spectrum, each bit in the original signal is represented by multiple bits in the transmitted signal using a spreading code. So we already seen in our frequency hopping spreading spread spectrum, the spreading code is used to select a particular frequency, and we are hopping from one frequency to another. But here it is not like that. The frequency will be spreaded, but that spreading of the frequency is achieved in a different way. What we are doing is, with an example it will be very clear for you. So what we are doing is, we will generate the spreading code using our pseudo random number generator or whatever it is, and now using with the help of this spreading code we will be means each bit we will spread into a number of bits. So that is the idea. We will see that example. Now the spreading code spreads the signal across a wider frequency band in direct proportion to the number of bits used, and that means a single bit is now represented by a more number of bits, right? As a result, the frequency is also increasing, okay, because we are keeping the time period fixed. So therefore, at 10-bit spreading code, suppose you are using 10-bit spreading code, in the sense each bit in the input signal will be spreaded over 10 bits. So, or each bit will be represented by 10 bits in the output after doing the spreading. That spreads the signal across a frequency band that is 10 times greater than the 1-bit spreading code. So initially it was when it was 1-bit spreading code, or when there is no spreading at all. If f is a frequency, then after spreading it across a 10-bit spreading using 10-bit spreading code, the new frequency will be 10 times as that of the original one. We will see how it is with an example. Now, one technique with the direct sequence spreading spread spectrum is to combine the digital information stream with the spreading code bit stream. Now, how this in the actual information is bit is spreaded over a number of bits, for that we can use the XOR operation. That is one way. Different methods are also there. Now, the XOR, you know how this XOR, that in digital electronics you already studied how this XOR is functioning, and if you don't know, it is like if you have 0 0, the XOR operation will produce the output as 0 0 1, output as 1 1 0, output as 1 1 1, output as 0. So if both of the inputs are same, that is 0 0 or 1 1, the output will be 0. If the inputs are for the XOR operation is different, then the output will be 1. So that is the way. And one more thing you can observe is, say to an XOR operator, let me take this as a first input, okay, and second input. So suppose the second input is 0, for example, second input is 0. Now see what is the relation between the first input and the output. If the second input is 0, the first input is, what is the first input, that will be coming as the output. Here also see, second input is 0. So if one of the input to the XOR operation is 0, it will act as a means identity for the XOR operation, in the sense what is the other input, that will be coming as the output. Now if the second input is 1, see in this the second and the fourth case, second input is 1, then what is there in the what is the other input, and its complement will be coming as the output. Here also this 1's complement 0 will be coming as the output. That is the thing. Now as an example we will see this. Here we have a data input, say A. This is the input we are trying to communicate, 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 1, whatever, and it's continuing like that. Now I locally generate the pseudo noise bit stream, just like the pseudo random number. Using that generator we'll be generating the bit stream like this. The bit stream is like a 0 1 1 0, so that is a bit, and we are 0 1 1 0, some okay, 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1. So it's, what is happening, some randomly generated, right? So from 4 bit is being generated by the pseudo random number generator in a random way. So initially and that process is repeating. This is a 4 bits generated, then another 4 bits, and that is something the attacker can't predict. It will keep on generating the sequence in its own way using us purely or maximum the random number generated with maximum randomness, it will be generated in this sequence. Now to the generated pseudo random number, this kind of some pattern, right? at any duration like this t, you can expect any pattern like this 4-bit pattern. Okay, now the transmitted signal will be how we will be combining the original input with the pseudo random generator, you can use the XOR operation. Okay, and you know how this XOR operation is working. So here we have a zero, say, represented by a high voltage, right? So to this zero, and you know what is zero XOR zero, the result is zero. So the normal XOR operation, here it is zero XOR one, the result is one, just like this. So it will keep on generating like this. So you can think of it like this. So this is the, just look at this duration, the pseudo random number generator is generating the sequence 0110, and the same sequence will be propagated to the output if the input bit at that point is zero, because that is what I was trying to convey in the previous slide. If for XOR operation, if one of the input is zero, what is the other one that will be coming as output? Then the zero is a kind of identity. Now if one of the input is one, what you can see is this 1001 is a spreading code being generated by this is just random. Okay, this is 0110, this is 1001, this is 0110, again 1011, like that. Some 4-bit pattern is being generated by the pseudo random number generator. Now by looking at this what is the other out input, its complement will be coming as output, just opposite, like this 1 will be coming as 0, 0 will be coming as 1, in that way. So as it is 0, just the code will be repeated. As it is 1, its complement will be coming. That is a very simple XOR operation here. Now at the receiver side also, you can do the same XOR operation, you will get the original signal back. Why? Because you know, this is the pattern being transmitted after doing this spreading, right? Now at the receiver side, suppose it is correctly received by the receiver without any problem. Now generate the same sequence, that is the 0110 1001, and you know, as the same algorithm and the seed will be used by the sender and receiver, so the receiver can generate the same sequence as that of the sender. So that is the assumption we are having, or we are supposed to make it means before starting your communication, it is the responsibility of the transmitter to communicate to the receiver somehow the pattern of the technique used to generate the pattern, then only it will work. Okay, now see, at this duration of time, what is happening? The input that is being received by the receiver and the pattern, both are looking same, right? So if both inputs are same, the output will be zero. You are getting this pattern. So both are getting same. Now when the in this case, say this is a input being received by the receiver and this is a pattern, and they are just looking complement, because so that is how we generate the signal, right? So when the inputs are complement to each other, the output is found to be one. This mouse pointer is getting stuck at some point. Okay, fine. So that is the thing. So now you are able to generate the signal exactly as that of the that is being sent by the sender. Okay, so hope you got an idea about it. So the figure shows an example. Note that an information bit of one inverts a spreading code bits in the combination, while an information bit of zero causes a spreading bit to be transmitted without any inversion. So that is something you can keep in your mind, so that you can draw this example faster without any you don't have to actually do that XOR operation. Simply if one of the input is zero, then repeat that pattern. Otherwise you give its complement, like that you can draw it. You take any random sequence. So the combination of bit stream has the data rate of the signal spreading code sequence. So it has a wider bandwidth than the information stream. I didn't mention it here. So for example, suppose the time period of this original signal be some t unit of time. Anyway, this half of the time period is highlighted in the figure, and you know how we are calculating the time period, the time taken to complete a cycle normally. So you just take the time from here to here. According to the figure, it will be 2 times of t. So let me assume it as t. Okay, the time period of the signal is t, in the sense the time from this point to this point, the time taken to complete a cycle, let it be t. Now you know what happened to our signal. So this is the original time period. After converting it like this, see, the cycle is something starting from here and it is ending at this point, right? This is another cycle, right? So what you can see that how the time period of the output signal is related to that of the input signal, right? Tell me how it is related. So this is the total time period of the input signal, and during that time only one cycle is being completed for the actual input. But see, during the same time, how many cycles are being completed? The cycle 1 and cycle 2, again cycle 3 and cycle 4, right? So 4 cycles are completed in the, since the time period is actually 1/4 of the original time period. So if the original time period is t for completing a cycle, now the time period is t/4. So how the time period and frequency are related? Time period, frequency, they are inversely proportional to each other, right? So for the original signal, the frequency is f, that is 1/T. For the new one, the frequency will be 1/T/4. So that it will be 4/T, that means 4 times the frequency of the original one. So as the spreading cord is generating a 4-bit pattern, it's multiplying the frequency of the original signal by 4. If it is a k-bit pattern in general, the output will be of k into f, that many times frequency as that of the input, or the bandwidth is becoming that times. I mean, spreading cord k-bit means the output bandwidth will be k times as that of the input. So that is the problem here. But as usual, as I already told you, here also you can think about that multiplexing, so that this even though you are spreading over a wider bandwidth, you can share it for a number of pair of devices for its communication, and with that we will see how it is done using a particular multiplexing scheme. So that about this, now that spreading we already read the combination of the bit stream as the data rate of the original spreading code sequence. So it has a wider bandwidth than the information. In this example, the spreading code bit stream is clocked at 4 times that of the information rate, or the frequency is getting 4 times, the time period is getting 1/4 of the original one. So it is simply the binary data is given to the modulator. It can be any binary to analog modulator. Particularly, an example is taken where the binary phase shift keying is used, and now the modulated signal, the analog signal, is being generated. But in the figure, we saw this output signal as digital, and we understood how that spreading is done using that XOR operation. But when it comes to analog signal, the same thing you can apply for analog signal also, and particular example we can see. Now using a pseudo noise bit stream, we are doing that direct sequence spreading, and the spectrum signal is coming as output, and that will be reached at the receiver using the same pattern. Direct sequence despreader will now despread the information, and the demodulator will be converting it back to the original binary data. Now to see how this technique works, let's assume that, because you know, just for your understanding, we taken that digital information represented by digital signal, and we try to see how this XOR operation, everything is happening. But in actual case, as I already told you, this is for analog signal, right? So you can use the binary phase shift keying modulation scheme. Now rather than 1 and 0, here +1 and -1 are used to represent two binary digits, just for the sake of explanation, and also in a practical case also, that is on convention we are using, just 1 0, +1 and -1 we are representing. In that case, the binary phase shift keying signal can be represented by, so this is a representation of the signal, that's all, the amplitude into the d of t, that is the original sequence, cos 2 pi fct, the frequency of the original signal. A is the amplitude of the signal, Fourier, fc is the carrier frequency of the, and d of t is a discrete function that takes on the value of +1 for 1-bit time if the corresponding time bit is 1, and -1 for 0. If the original binary information is 1, and then this d of t will be +1. I mean, it will be represented by a high voltage, and something like that, +1, and for 0 it will be represented by -1. Okay, we are representing like that. Now to produce the direct sequence spectrum signal, above equation is multiplied by c of t, which is the pseudo noise sequence taking on values of plus 1 and minus 1, like as we already seen, we will be multiplying it with the pseudo noise signal, so that for the original signal this is multiplied by the C of t. Now at the receiver, the incoming signal is again multiplied back by the same pseudo noise generator. Now how the pseudo noise generator, when you are multiplying it with itself again, the output will be 1. We will see that. So that when the C of t and C of t, actually to this signal you are multiplying it with the C of t one more time at the receiver side, so these two will be converges to 1, so that it is just the original signal. Okay, and therefore the original signal is required like this. C of t is the random noise, right, being generated by the, so just like this we have this original data represented in the form of plus 1 and minus 1, say like 1 and 0, plus 1 minus 1, like that we are represented, its time period is denoted. Now the signal is being converted using binary phase shift keying, and you know how that BPSK is working. For plus 1 it is just like this, and when it comes to minus 1 the amplitude is just inverted, right, the phase is inverted, just like now the signal is like this, now the signal is simply inverted like this. Okay, similarly, and when it comes to 1 again it is inverted, and that phase is just shifting from the current value when that value is then changing from plus 1 to minus 1, minus 1 to plus 1, for example. Now the spreading code is something like this, again 1 and 0 treated like plus 1 and minus 1, and plus 1 means it is just like this, and when it comes to minus 1 the phase is being inverted, again it is inverted. Okay, plus 1 it is, so whenever plus 1 is coming the previous phase it will try to continue, when minus 1 is coming the previous phase it will change, some 180 degree shift will happen. Okay, that is the thing. So that's all. At the receiver side also, using the same code, it will try to multiply so that it will get this original signal back, then using BPSK demodulator it will take the original signal. Just an example only, and I think the previous example will be more clear for you, like that spreading and everything. We when you are looking it as a digital signal, it is more or clear. Here some other sine wave properties also we have to understand for getting it more and more detail. So anyway, you got an idea, right? So the same bit is being spread over multiple bits with the help of the pseudo random number generator. Okay, so that is the idea. Thank you. So that about direct sequence spread spectrum.